Dear students, today we will discuss about the Drugs and Cosmetic Act and Rules 95, the second part. So, in the first part we have discussed the basic concept of the Drugs and Cosmetic Act. So, we have discussed about some definition, some schedules. So, the main objective of the Act I have discussed in that last class, to control over the manufacture, sale and distribution of drugs. So, these three things are controlled by Drugs and Cosmetic Act. So, today we will discuss the main part, that is manufacture of the drugs. So, if you consider manufacture of the drugs, then mainly I have discussed some schedules to the act in the last class. So, drugs are major category of drugs are kept in three categories. One is your manufacture of drugs other than schedule C and C1. Manufacture of drugs listed in schedule C and C1 and manufacture of schedule X drugs. So, these are three main categories of drugs. Besides this, some other loan license is there, some repacking license are there, and offense and penalties. Lastly, we will deal with this topic regarding manufacture of drugs. So, first we will discuss the, of course, some drugs, some drugs are prohibited to be manufactured in India. So, that category of drugs we'll discuss. So, number one is your drugs not of the standard quality, or any misbranded drugs, or any adulterated drugs, or any spurious drugs. I have discussed earlier in the definition. So, that category of drugs cannot be produced in India. Second thing is your patent and property drugs, that also which true formula is not disclosed, that can be also not prohibited to be manufactured. And other thing is schedule J drugs. I have also told you schedule J drugs, the drugs which cannot, that is diseases are kept there which cannot claim to cure. That category of drugs also cannot be manufactured. So, another risky to human beings or animals, drugs without therapeutic value and preparation containing cyclamates. So, that category of drugs are not, so this is not much important. So, for examination point of view, we will discuss the major things now. Then, what are, in the examination, some questions may come about that thing. What are the conditions a manufacturer may fulfill to manufacture schedule C and C1 drugs, or schedule other than schedule C1 drugs, or schedule X drugs. So, that may come in as a question in the examination. So, whatever the question will come, the general format will be same, and some changes are there that we will discuss. So, first we will discuss about the drugs for one license is required, which are not in schedule C and C1 categories. So, you know schedule C and C1 categories, that is biological drugs. So, other than this series, all drugs like paracetamol, acetaminophen, all these are coming, analgene, are coming under, that is other than schedule C and C1 drugs. So, that category of drugs, for what are the conditions a licensee must fulfill? Number one is that he must comply with the schedule M. So, I have told schedule M, the requirement for GMP, for good manufacturing practices, that condition is a must for any category of drugs. Then, adequate facility for testing and separate room for manufacturing. So, one other thing that manufacturing houses, when you join in a manufacturing sector, you know that some manufacturing houses should be there, there and testing units will be separate. In this other building, testing will be there. So, then some storage facility will be there, adequate storage facility will be there, and any drugs, the records should be maintained up to 2 years. And drugs inspector or something, the authority is there, or any competent authority may be allowed to inspect your premises where drugs are manufactured. Stability data you have to comply. If he wants some sample, then he can take. So each batch, every batch, you can keep some reference samples. So likewise, for Schedule C and CN drugs, some other conditions are there. This is what I have explained. This is a common thing. Besides this, in for Schedule C and C1, I have told biological drugs, some special precaution will be taken. The drug must be should be supplied in sterilized glasses or sterilized containers. That should comply with the Schedule A. Some anaerobic or aerobic test for serum, vaccine, etc. can be tested. Some parenteral doses, some 10 ml or more than this, should be tested for pyrogen. So these are some special condition or sterility test to be done. So these have to be mentioned in the other, if it is coming, Schedule C and C1 drugs is coming. If the question will come that license to get a Schedule X drug for preparation of Schedule X drugs, or narcotic drugs, what I have told earlier, some habit forming drugs, then some these precautions, these conditions have to be fulfilled by the manufacturer. But that accounts of transaction all should be maintained up to 5 years, it should be there. It can be checked by that the licensing authority who will license the license, who will give the license. So the preparation must be labeled as per Schedule X. So Schedule X drugs, some that label should be in the RX should be there in the corner of the your press, that is your any strip of the drugs or any vial. 100 unit of drug, that is doses for tablet and capsule, maximum doses, that is there. So these are some conditions what I have listed in the chart, that is in the, so you have to maintain that for getting a license. Then other thing I have told that this is very important, some short question of type thing will come in the exam, so loan license. So besides this, that is government has authorized to issue some loan license. So what is a loan license? The definition is there, it is written there, you see, just a person, any applicant who does not have his own arrangement, own factory for manufacture, but who wish to or intend to manufacture the facilities owned by another licensee, such license are called loan license. That means he has not know any individual, his own unit, but he can manufacture his drugs in a firm who has got that license for that category of drugs. So loan license are also issued for drugs other than specified in Schedule C and C1 drugs and X drugs separately, and drugs specified in Schedule C and C1. So that provision is there. So that the authorities, licensing authority, will issue a loan license. Then other is your repacking license. So drugs are repacking means a bulk drugs will be converted to small portion by means of repacking. So for that also provision is in the act is there for repacking of license. So what is there is process of breaking up any drug or bulk form into a small package and labeling with a view to their sale and distribution is known as your repacking of drugs. So repacking of drugs for other conditions is to maintain all storage conditions, etc. All other things, whatever the main license, in besides this, he has to maintain that the other things, but for Schedule C and C1 drugs and Schedule X drugs, it is not permitted. the packing of drugs for other than Schedule C and C1 will be given, but for the Schedule C and C1 drugs, and why it is not given? You know, Schedule C and C1 drugs are biological drugs. So biological drugs, when it is dispensed in sterile form, so when you can break it, so it will become unsterile. So that in that category of drugs, government is not allowing repacking license. And also Schedule X drugs, that is your narcotic drugs. So many precautions are there. The narcotic drugs are very adverse actions are there. So for that also government is not giving any repacking license for it. So this is about your exemption point of view. Any license that they can ask in the examination. So if you have to prepare for that thing, then what are the condition licensee must fulfill to get this category of license which I have discussed. It may be a Schedule C1, that is other than Schedule C1 or Schedule X. Anything it can be come, but in this line you have to write. Then lastly, we have discussed about the offense and penalties of the manufacturer of drugs. So offense and penalties of the manufacturer of drugs is that any if you are committing an that is you are not contravening the act, we are doing a offense. So any for that a penalty is there. So manufacturing of adulterated drugs or spurious drugs, any substandard drugs like this thing, as per the section 320 of the Indian Penal Code, that 5 years of life imprisonment is there and not less than 10,000 rupees fine is there. So if anybody will be doing that offense, is not obeying the act like this thing, the this penalty is there. So and other thing is there, manufacturer of drugs without license or adulterated drugs not likely to cause any death. In this case, first case, that it is likely to cause death also. This consuming this spurious drug, all adulterated drugs. But in second case, if it is harmful but not causing the death or grievous body of any heart, for that 1 to 3 years of imprisonment and not less than 5,000 fine is there. And other manufacturing of drugs in contravention of the any of the provision, whatever the provision in the act is there, 1 to 2 years of imprisonment is there. So this is the basically other thing is that they are there, but these three mainly offense and penalties you remember for your exemption point of view. So today this much about your manufacture of drugs today, and next we'll start with your sale of drugs. So thank you all for attending this year online class. Again, thank you.